And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You've got everything going your way. You've probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
The first down throw coming for Dalton. Rolling to his left. He's going to air it out. And got his man complete. The 20, 10, and all the way in for a Cincinnati score.
I had to be, I had to take a video of that.
Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Bengals have broken our tie as they take the lead.
Hell yeah.
And it's good. That makes it a 28-21 game. Bullock out now to kick this one away.
That's
fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. The Ravens offense getting ready now for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play.
How many plays do you script?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
Well, that incompletion gives us an opportunity to talk about what some people dubbed Shutout Sunday this last week in the NFL. What, we have three shutouts?
Yeah, for the first time since 2012, that's the total number of shutouts last season.
Yeah.
How about Denver getting shut out by the Chargers? That's the first shutout for the Broncos since 1992, 394 games worth. So that's a big deal. The Colts, goose egg against Jacksonville. Jacksonville also put 10 sacks on them in that game. And the Cardinals went all the way to London, Twickenham Stadium, in fact, to get shut out by the division rival LA Rams.
Defenses reign supreme. First and 10, and Flacco looking to throw to the right side, and he's got Macklin.
I'm surprised ain't none of y'all go for
it.
He'll
get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of until they stop him.
The Bengals. You were so lucky, bro. Down he goes. Carlos Dunlap in there to get him for his second sack of the night.
Every time I'm about to
That's his second sack of the game, and the best defensive ends, they do their homework as much as offensive guys do. They know how to beat the offensive lineman across from them, what moves they need to do to set them up. This guy's been pretty good at it all game long.
Now it's Flacco.
Fuck no.
Third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked up by the linebacker, Kevin Minter. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line.
My man's had his hand in the other guy's arms. What?
Their D gets the INT. Now what can Dalton do? Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. Showed the nice footwork and then hit and dropped shy of the 45. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll make it a second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
And he stopped immediately there. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
Man, they fucking have a first down
as they get him to the ground at the 37.
What are y'all doing?
A Bengal first down, Dalton hitting LaFell.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Dalton throwing on second down. Trying to get it to LaFell, but it's intercepted. Picked off at the 21.
The
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Looking left side, that's caught by Macklin.
Good thought.
And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Jeremy Macklin, his second touchdown of the night. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. He's got it. This thing's turning a bit wild here. We're tied at 28. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here. That'll be taken in the end zone.
Shootout.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
Back now in Baltimore. With a give here to Mixon, and he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people, because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers, because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they will just roam and hit.
10 yards there on a Bengal first.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
Dalton, first and 10. It's complete.
Why didn't you stay on him?
Taken down at the 46-yard line.
You retired or something?
There on the first down completion. Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Second down, Dalton. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the longtime Charger, Eric Weddle. And a great return here gets this one all the way down to the 26-yard line. Well, Charles, he's thrown 5 picks in a game before, and right now after that one, he's standing on number 4.
And right now your defensive coordinator is asking the offense coordinator, can you do anything to slow this down? Because my guys have to keep running back out on the field, so play calling may come into it a little bit, maybe run the ball a little bit more, but a lot of it depends on the scoreboard. They may have to keep throwing it.
He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
It'll be a pickup of 8 and a good first step there with second and goal coming up. Now, what's the thinking here? Because a touchdown would be nice, but you've ensured yourself a chance at 3 in the lead, so how worried are you about the 6?
You're not very worried about if you're confident in your kicker. And if you got a kicker who can put it through the post, you feel really good about trying to bleed that clock down. In an ideal scenario, your kicker puts it through the post as the clock hits 0s.
Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's 3rd and goal.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any.
And he'll get in! Touchdown, Baltimore! Nick Boyle, a beast in the red zone with his second touchdown of the game. And the Ravens have used the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. And this one through the uprights and good. Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. He'll look to throw. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. Give him five on the screen play, and that'll set up a third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. That one will go down as 33 yards on the third down conversion. He's back to throw. Oh, no, lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Back to throw. He's going to let it fly. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by the longtime Charger, Eric Weddle. And he will take this all the way up past the 40-yard line. Interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown five picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran the wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
He's got a man wide open. It's Macklin. And they'll get him to the ground, but he got all the way down to the 30-yard line. A big gain there, and that should certainly be enough to put this one in the win column.
Not on the right fucking button.
How about this? Flacco setting to throw it. He hits his target, left side, Watson. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. Give him nine there on the first down completion. Flacco, he's going to go up top for the end zone. And they went for a big play through the air on second down, couldn't connect. Now it's third.
Not too many missteps in the red zone thus far. He was going for his fifth touchdown pass. His man couldn't shake free there, but boy, you know he's going to take another shot before this one's over.
Yeah, exactly, because you know three is good, four is excellent. You get five, that's a whale of a game.
On third and one, I think everyone in the stadium thought they'd try and run the football there, but they tried to surprise the defense and hit something through the air. Instead, it results in an incompletion.
And now the Bengals are going to call another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a two-score game. And Tucker's kick right there. It's good. And that will push the lead up to double digits now at 10. So barring something extraordinary, something crazy here in the closing stages, that field goal should just about put this one on ice.
Brandon, this will be a great win for them. The better team's going to win this game, no question about it. And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel
how you know the
right,
ball is on the fucking ground and you keep running backwards?
And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Now a desperation throw deep, and this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off here by Jimmy Smith, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. What a nightmarish game he's having now. Six interceptions that he has thrown.
Absolutely unbelievable, isn't it? Hard to believe we're watching this and have seen it, but it just tells you about the game of football. It giveth and it taketh away.
Yeah, he's got a man. end complete.